Hello, dear colleagues. My name is Evgenia Agapova. I am a doctor from St. Luca Clinical Hospital, St. Petersburg, Russia. This report about intermittent catheterization for patients with bladder outlet obstruction with urinary retention. Bladder decompression is often required to restore detrusor contractility for patients with acute and chronic urinary retention due to benign prostatic obstruction. In Russia, suprapubic of indwelling urethral catheters is used for these purposes, which have their out advantages, disadvantages, and complications. Intermittent catheterization is the standard treatment for patients with impaired bladder, emptying due to nephrological issues. Intermittent catheterization was proposed for patients with spinal cord injury in the 14 by a German neurosurgeon, founder of the Paralympic, James Ludwig Gammon. The International Continent Society identifies three types of catheters for intermittent bladder catheterization: uncoated catheters with superlight applied lubricant, pre-lubrication catheters, hydrophilic coated lubricated catheters. The different types of catheters on the slide. The worst complication of different types of urinary deviations. Suprapubic catheters is associated with high frequency of urinary tract infection, the risk of bladder capacity reduction, low quality of life. Intermittent catheterization is associated with urinary tract infection, risk of urethral traumatization and development of urethral stricture with insufficient lubricant of the catheter and the complexity of learning. Advantages of intermittent catheterization is more physiological for the patients, he sees infection and inflammatory complication and does not require medical supervision. The aim of our study is to evaluate the efficacy and safety of intermittent catheterization in patients with bladder outlet obstruction complicated by urinary retention. The result of treatment of 33 patients were analyzed. Patients were divided into two groups. The first group included 37 patients to underwent suprapubic cystectomy and the second 26 patients who were offered intermittent catheterization. The examination included standard blood test, PCI test, bladder ultrasound with post-vital residual measurement, pressure flow study, and bladder diuresis. The analysis of the conducted studies showed that in both groups there was a decrease of bladder capacity on the 10th day in the suprapubic cystectomy group by 12% and in the intermittent catheterization group by 18%. The number of infection and inflammatory complication in the first group was 4%, in the second 2% respectively. This intermittent catheterization is an alternative method of urinary deviations with FIV intra and postoperative complication, which makes it possible to recommend this technique as a method of choice for preoperative bladder drainage. Thank you for your attention.